Hi, welcome back to the shop. Today I'm going to be talking about the MS661C chainsaw from Stihl. So I bought this chainsaw for the sole reason of milling logs with a chainsaw mill. And I wanted a saw that was big enough that I didn't have to worry about the saw burning up right away. I wanted it to be from a good company. I've had good luck with Stihl in the past. And I also wanted it to have enough power to be able to put the really long bars on it if I needed to. This is actually the original bar that came on the saw. I think it's a 28-inch bar. And I use this bar primarily for cutting firewood. It's got a firewood chain on it at the moment. It works awesome for cutting firewood too. It's got tons of power. Slices right through pine, no problem. And I've used it more than I thought actually for that, even though I have a smaller saw. This one is just so much faster that I end up using this one a fair amount of the time too. I also have a 32-inch Stihl bar, and yeah, that works great. I've used it on a mill a fair amount, as you can see. I've even used that one on a mill. And then I also have a 42-inch Oregon bar, and this bar also works great. I've used it on this saw with a mill a number of times. It's always worked perfect, and so I can vouch for the fact that this will run a 42-inch bar no problem through ash. And that's, what more can you ask, really? So to change the bar on these saws, all you need to do is just remove these two nuts. If you want to tighten or loosen the chain, there is a small regular screw head inside of this, and Stihl gives you a tool that you can stick in there and turn one way or the other to make this looser or tighten it. The filter is a round type filter, and there's really nothing to that. Just clean it out once in a while. Mine still has the original filter. It still looks fine to me. You just take it out, take this back off, take it out, pull it straight out, and then just tap it on a table or a rock or whatever's around, and it'll clear the chips out. Usually the chips are pretty big, and so they just kind of fall out, and I just then replace the filter, blow it out a little bit, and then you're good to go. The other amazing thing about this saw over some other Stihl saws is the ease of start with these professional level saws. They actually have a button that's right up here that's a pressure release on the cylinder, and you just push that down and you'll hear it click, and then you can push down the trigger and the little safety switch here and push the switch all the way down to the bottom position. The switch actually looks quite a bit different than other Stihl saws that I've used in the past. It just is a three-way position, and you put it in the down position to start it up. There's actually a computer in here that will match the altitude, whatever you're at, to the saw to make it run at the right settings. And as soon as you give it some gas and pull the trigger, that switch will pop up to the middle position, and it is all ready to go then. It should be on and running, and you don't have to touch it anymore. When you're ready to turn it off, you just push the switch up and it will turn it off. Really simple there. Like I said, the computer takes care of almost all of it for you. Let it sit there and run, warm up a little bit, and then you're good to go. That part of the saw, just starting it, is so much simpler than some of the other saws, and it just works so much better with this compression release button. I've had this saw about 3 years. I've had it into the shop one time, and that was because it was really flooded one time. I'm not exactly sure how that happened, but they flushed it and put in a new spark plug, and ever since then it's been fine, and that's been at least a year ago. So I really have had no issues, and I've cut probably hundreds of slabs with this saw. So would I buy this chainsaw again if I was looking for a saw to maybe hook to an Alaskan mill and cut big slabs, or maybe the ultimate firewood cutting chainsaw? I absolutely would. This saw has done everything I've asked it to do and more. And I think probably most importantly, it starts up again the next time and works again. It's got professional level performance. It's built really well. It's easy to change the bar and chain. It's easy to start. It holds enough gasoline and oil to get through a couple of pretty large slabs. And it just feels like a quality tool. And I think Stihl did a really awesome job with this chainsaw. So if you're in the market, I would recommend you give it a look. Take a look at some of the bars that you can get for it. Does the other brand bars seem to work just as good as the Stihl bars? So take a look and see what's out there. I think this saw will fit most people's needs. It's definitely fit mine. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you next time.